صلى الله عليك يا سيدي ويا مولاي يا رسول الله صلى الله عليك يا سيدي ومولاي وابن مولاي يا شهيد كربلاء يا أبا عبد الله طبتم وطابت الأرض التي فيها دفنتم ما خاب من تمسك بكم سادتي وأمنا يا مثواكم يا ليتنا يا كنا معكم فنفوز فوزا عظيما. اجى المهدي بدموع الجرية يحاكي علي للغضرية يزور بالدمع هالليلة والعبرة ويقرا الفاتحة بحسرة على قبره. يا جدي ورثيت منك بكائك على الضامي كل عمرك ندائك على كبده وعلى قلبه وعلى نحره ويقرأ الفاتحة بحسرة على قبره. المهدي came tears flowing on his holy cheeks with Karbala's sick imam he sits and speaks. He visits him in grief at Maqi'an with us tonight, reads Al-Fatiha and prays in sorrow at his gravesite. He says, on your grave I came to lament and cry. I recall, dear grandfather, how your time in chains was spent. I inherited the tears you cried till you bled as you watched your father Hussein's paraded head. Grandfather Sajjad, your agony and cries passed down to me for the thirsty one whom I avenge when Allah decrees. For his dry lips, unbearable thirst, and for his slaughter. And I wash your lonely grave in Baqi' with tears instead of water. Imam Zainul Abidin narrates to his son Imam Al-Baqir, the army of Umar ibn Sa'd carried me on a camel with no saddle from Karbala to Kufa to Sham chained, and my father's head on a spear. Every time I would lean or slip off, the guards would hit me with their spears. And every time we would cry for our father Hussein, they would strike us on the back of our heads, ordering us to stop. The women were carried on mules and their faces exposed. How could we fathom the daughters of Rasulullah being paraded like this while the whips fall upon their backs? The army of Umar ibn Sa'd, la'anahu Allah, entered Kufa, playing drums and trumpets, while accompanying the women of Ahlul Bayt, striking their chests, wailing and crying. The people of Kufa began to weep loudly and scream out of sorrow, as if Rasulullah himself had passed. Whereupon Kulthum began to say, Ya Ahlul Kufa, غضوا أبصاركم عنا أما تستحون من الله ورسوله أن تنظروا إلى حرم رسول الله وهن حواسر. O people of Kufa, lower your gaze. Are you not ashamed of Allah and His Prophet to stare upon the women of Ahlul Bayt in this state? One of the narrators describes that he witnessed a woman in a dreadful state on a camel without a saddle, and behind her a young sick man crying from the pain with blood gushing from his feet. It was Imam Zainul Abidin, wrapped in chains tightly by the neck. Al-Jami'a fi sadri. Here the women of Kufa began to distribute dates and bread to the children of Ahlul Bayt. Sayyida Zainab cried out, taking back the food and throwing it back to them, saying, We Ahlul Bayt cannot accept sadaqah, for sadaqah upon us is haram. Here the people of Kufa cried and screamed in despair. It's as if I see Sayyida Zainab look towards Karbala and call Abu Fadl, her protector, and say, Ana min al-Madina tla'at wayyak wayyak uchini tul al-darab ya khoy bihmak يصير أصبح سبي بولية عداك يباريني زجر لو سرت بالبر يا خويا يا بعد عقلي والأنفاس يا راعي المرجل المقيوب عباس ترضى أروح مهبط الراس وأنا زينب أبويا الليل Haydar, I left Medina with you, brother, by my side. I was in your protection, you were always wherever I reside. How could I become a captive in the hands of evil and watched by strange eyes? How could you not come running to aid me when you heard my cries? How could I be in this state? How could this happen to me when my brother is the staunch Abbas? And my father is the hero Ali. In the gathering of the women of Kufa, Banu Azd, who are a staunch tribe, saw one of their women sitting beside Sayyida Zainab as a captive. They called her by her name, but she did not answer. They then threatened her, saying, If you do not come to us, we will enter in between the women and forcefully grab you, as your captivity brings shame to our tribe. Sayyida Zainab told her to answer to their commands. The lady looked at Sayyida Zainab and replied, How do I abandon you? And no one from your tribe has called you. Sayyida Zainab told her not to worry about her and go. This woman had a tribe of men to call her and remove her from humiliation. But where are the Hashimid men to call Zainab? Where is Hussein? Where is Abbas, her protector? Where is Ali Akbar? Where is Al-Qasim? Where is Muslim? Where are her sons, Aun and Muhammad? As if I can see Sayyida Zainab turn to her tribe. Where is her tribe? Paraded as heads on spears. She looks at the head of Imam Hussein. تقول يا شايل راس حامي نولينا ريض خلت وادعس كنا ليش حسين ساكت عن ونينا قل لي تعب يا جرحات خدار يا شيال راسلت لوحة وهبت عني بجاي الروز رمحة أخاف يفوت ريح الهوى بجرحه وصواب عليه يقوم يسعار. Oh, you who raises the head of my beloved Hussein on a spear, slow down, let Sukaina farewell him in her flow of tears. Do not wave the spear, I'm afraid the wind will hurt him. Ease your steps, these are the memories your sister Zainab forever kept. The Ahlul Bayt were taken to the palace of Ibn Ziyad in Kufa. Sayyida Zainab entered with a veil on her face. As they were taken to the court of Ibn Ziyad, la'anahullah, he approached Sayyida Zainab after asking who she was and said to her, I have heard that Ali used to say to turn off the lamp so no one can see the shadow of Zainab. And here you are in front of me. All thanks to Allah for exposing your lies and killing you. Sayyida Zainab replied, rather surely, all thanks is to Allah who honored us with his prophet Muhammad and purified us the best of purification. The only one exposes the hypocrite and wicked, and that is other than us. Ibn Ziyad turns to Imam Zainul Abidin and asks, who is this? One of his men replies, this is Ali, son of Hussein. Ibn Ziyad cunningly asks, did Allah not kill Ali, son of Hussein, in Karbala? Imam al-Sajjad replied, I had a brother named Ali, and the people killed him. They tore him to pieces. قَطَّعُوهُ إِرَبًا إِرَبًا. Ibn Ziyad emphasizes, no, Allah killed him. The Imam then recites the verse, Allah yatawaffa al-anfus hina mawtiha wal-lati lam tamut fi manamiha. Allah takes away the souls at the time of their deaths and those who die not during their sleep. Ibn Ziyad says angrily, and you have the audacity to answer me, strike his neck immediately. Sayyida Zainab then throws herself on the Imam, crying out, oh, Ibn Ziyad, is it not enough you have killed his family? If you intend to kill him, then kill me first. صاحت زينب لزمت ذياله يا ابن زياد ترحم سقم حاله عدل خلي واذبحني بداله غير اله الودايع بعد ما تم. زينب cries out, clinging on to nephew the Imam, here you are not satisfied your thirst for blood by slaughtering Hussein like a ram. Kill me instead, do not harm him, for he is ill. But we were saved from such acts, for this was Allah's will. The Imam tells his aunt to quiet down and says to Ibn Ziyad, do you threaten me with death, Ibn Ziyad? Do you not know that death for us is habitual and our honor is in martyrdom? Now Ibn Ziyad turns to Ar-Rabab, and he intentionally wanted to make her suffer. Pointing at Hussein's head, he asked, whose head is this? She did not flinch. He asked her again. She did not reply. He asked her a third time, saying, by this person's right over you, tell me who it is. She replied with tears, this is the head of my master Hussein. and life is useless and has no taste after. She then took the holy head, embraced it, and began to kiss it. Oh, Hussein, how can I forget Hussein? And the sores did not sow. Left him torn in Karbala, thirsty with no head for people to know. She refused to give back the head, so they whipped her and took it. Zayn Abbas, why would you do such a thing? Rabab said, when my master said his farewells to the Imam, I was embarrassed and could not fathom him leaving, so I stayed in my tent. And when he was killed, my heart was burned, burning, because I did not come to say goodbye. So when I saw his head, I took it and kissed it to make up for that day. Rasu ibn binti Muhammadin wa wasiyyi للناظرين على قناة يرفع، والمسلمون بمسمع وبمنظر لا منكر منهم ولا متفجع. Oh, son of Fatima, your head is raised on spears up high, and Muslims blind and deaf towards this and the tragedy they deny. As the Ahlul Bayt were paraded in Kufa, the bodies of the martyrs lay headless on the sands of Karbala for 3 days. They asked Imam Zainul Abidin, what was the hardest thing on your heart? Was it the killing of your brother? He said, Hanat. Was it the killing of your cousins? He said, Hanat. Was it the killing of your uncle Abbas? He said, Hanat. Was it the slaughter of your father and your baby brother? He said, Hanat. What did he reply? Asham, Asham, Asham. أنا ما نكست راسي لجل ذبح الصناديد، ما قصروا بالغاضرية زلزلوا البيد. أنا نكس راسي يدخلون زينب المجلس يزيد. كيف دخلت زينب المجلس؟ تقول بس هاي ما كانت على البال، أطب المجلس وبزنود الإحبال. السجاد يقول طبينا المجلس والله بيا حال، أنا الجامع بصدري ومجدوف النساء والأطفال. فعل يزيد ما أنسى وما أنسى ديوان، أنا قدام النساء والأطفال تناول رأس مولانا. I did not lower my head when they slaughtered my loved ones and I watched them bleed. What broke me is when they forced us to enter, chained the courts of Yazid. How did Zainab enter? As if I can hear her say, out of all the tragedies, I never thought this would happen to me. Dragged like a slave, tied in front of strange men as they curse my father Ali. As Sajjad says, with a collar on my neck, we entered in a dreadful state. Women and children chained while we watched them put my father's head on a plate. I will never forget what Yazid did on that day. He lifted my father's head by his gray hair and began to poke and play in plain sight of the women and children and my eyes. Do you understand why now, for the rest of my days, I cried, إن لله وإنا إليه راجعون. وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون والعاقبة للمتقين.